Hello friends, my name is Vikas.
So friends, in this video we will be discussing some of the important current affairs of first week of December. This video will be very helpful to you, so do watch the video till the end. So friends, we'll start with our session, but before that we have something important to tell you about.
So students, we have an app by the name Careers Cloud which you can go and download using the Play Store, and it is available only for the Android users as of now. Once you have downloaded and opened the app, you will see a page such as the second screen here. Then you just need to log in with your Google ID or you can say with your Gmail ID on this application, and once you have logged in, you are ready to use the particular application. As you can see, you will be seeing here My Course, All Courses, Crack Current Affairs. Just click on any of those and you will be directed to a second page. Here now, what are the features or why we recommend you to use the app? Because on the app, we provide you daily current affairs both in English as well as in Hindi. Both Hindi and English current affairs are provided you daily along with the quiz sessions. This is important. We provide you daily with the quiz sessions that will help you to brush up your current affairs that you gained today through our video or any other notes provided. These English and Hindi PDFs are also provided to you daily. This is provided on our app course that you can go and purchase. Two types of courses are there, 1 year plan and a second year plan, which you can opt as per your need. Then we provide you with weekly videos. Not just weekly videos on YouTube and monthly videos, daily videos are also given. Apart from that, weekly PDFs of current affairs are provided to you. Compiled PDF of current affairs of the whole week will be provided to you, both in English as well as in Hindi. Then similarly for the month also, you will be provided a compiled video of the whole month, both in English as well as in Hindi. PDF for the current affairs that will brush up your current affairs very much. Apart from this, we provide you with the topic wise current affairs, topics such as apps and web portals, important days, books and authors, then comes your sports, then comes your obituary, national affairs, international affairs, sports. These all topics are covered by us on our YouTube channel, which you can go and check it out also. Very important this section, because we provide you with the PDFs also with them that helps you to revise through a particular order, and it is very helpful to you, so you should definitely check it out. Then apart from it, we provide you questions regarding your particular exams also, such as bank, related to your banking. We provide you questions, we provide you PDF, we provide you material that will help you to revise those topics, those important topics. So very important. Alright, so I definitely recommend you to check our app and do revise and to purchase the courses, because they will be very helpful to you. These, I strongly recommend you to use our app as well as website, and the quiz provided on the app is very helpful to you on the daily basis, and our monthly study material for your exams will do wonders. So do watch the video for the revision purposes. They are very helpful. And if you use my code VIKAS10, straight away you will be getting an additional 10% discount on the purchase you made using the application. So additional discount for you students, just from my side. It is a happy hour sale, you can say. 10% discount using VIKAS10. So friends, let's start with our session now. So friends, let's start. First, we'll be going through some important one-liners, and then based on these one-liners, we'll be moving to the MCQ questions for the revision purpose. So let's start. First national news is Nagaland police has launched Call Your Cop mobile application for your citizens. So Call Your Cop mobile application launched by which state police? Launched by Nagaland state police. Center has formed a committee to review criteria for reservations for EWS that will be headed by Ajay Bhushan Pandeji. Mark this. Next, Niti Aayog committee has released a report on online dispute resolution that will be headed by Arjun Kumar Sikriji. Very important, do take a note of this, that a report on online dispute resolutions was released by which organization? By Niti Aayog. That will be headed by whom? Arjun Kumar Sikriji. Next comes your Hornbill Festival to be celebrated in Naga Heritage Village of Nagaland. As we all know, this Hornbill Festival is celebrated by people of Nagaland.
Next comes your Walmart and Flipkart has signed an MOU with the Madhya Pradesh government to train and support MSMEs. Another important. ADB, that is your Asian Development Bank, has approved a $50 million loan to Government of India for enhancing quality of school education. Jharkhand's Chief Minister has launched Hamar Apan Budget web portal and mobile application for the budget session. I repeat, Hamar Apan Budget was launched by Jharkhand Chief Minister and it is a kind of a web portal and application for budget suggestion. Government will launch Shrestha scheme for the development of SC students. Next is your Earth Station of Doordarshan Kendra inaugurated in Gorakhpur, UP. Smart Cities Mission's implementation's timeline has been extended to June 2023. That means the Smart Cities Mission for the implementation of the Smart Cities has been expanded to June 2023. Next is your Pradhan Mantri Modi has inaugurated multiple projects worth 18,000 crore rupees at Dehradun, Uttarakhand. IREDA has signed an MOU with THDCIL to support renewable energy projects. Gujarat became the first largest manufacturing hub according to RBI. Very important. Mark this. That which state become the largest manufacturing hub as per the RBI's data, it was your Gujarat. Government expanded steering committee for advancing local value added and exports with three new members that will be headed by Pawan Goenkaji. And the last one is also very important. You should mark this. Kazu Valley Wetland has been declared as the 16th bird sanctuary of Tamil Nadu. Which Kazu Valley Wetland declared as what? Declared as 16th bird sanctuary of Tamil Nadu. So these were some of your national affairs. Now let's shift to the international news. ADB, that is your Asian Development Bank, will be providing a $125 million loan for Uttarakhand water supply and sanitation projects. South Korea will build world's first floating city by 2025. Very important news. Which country will be building the world's first floating city? It is your Saudi Korea, and by what year? By 2025. Next, who was appointed as the first female of Sweden? Very important question. Who is she? Magdalena Andersson became the first female president of or first female prime minister of Sweden. India joined the G20 Troika with Indonesia and Italy. Troika was joined by Indonesia, Italy and India. Very important, mark this Troika. EIU's Worldwide Cost of Living Index 2021. Tel Aviv, that Israel's ranked world's most cost of living city, that means the world's most expensive city is Tel Aviv of Israel according to the World Cost of Living Index of 2021. Tel Aviv, a city of Israel, became the ranked one, that means it became the world's most expensive city. Next is your World Cooperative Monitor Report of 2021. IFCO ranked the first among top 300 cooperatives in the world according to the World Cooperative Monitor rank of 2021. Next is your India and European Union will set up clean energy and climate partnership. Mark this. A clean energy and climate partnership will be set up by India and European Union. Next, World Bank has approved a $135 million loan to improve efficiency reliability of electric supply in West Bengal. ADB, that is your Asian Development Bank, got 15 crore rupees grant from JFPR to improve the urban primary health care in India. EAM's Jay Shankar addressed 5th Indian Ocean Conference that was held in Abu Dhabi. Mark this, that the 5th Indian Ocean Conference, that is your 5th IOC, was held in Abu Dhabi. Very important, you should know this. Next comes your Adama Barrow has won the second term as the president of Gambia. Adama Barrow has won the second term, or he has been appointed as the president of Gambia for the second term. You should know this. Moving on to the appointments and resignations. RBI suspended Reliance Capital Board appointed Nageshwar Rao as their administrator. Manoj Kumar Magoji has been appointed as the commandant of National Defense College. Smriti Mandhana appointed as the brand ambassador of Guvi and IITM incubated startup. Geeta Gopinath will be appointed as the new first deputy managing director of IMF, that is your International Monetary Fund, headquarter of which is in Washington, D.C. Remember this name, Geeta Gopinath will be appointed as the new first deputy managing director of International Monetary Fund. Mark this, very important. Next comes your Sanjay Dutt signed as brand ambassador for 50th year celebration of Arunachal Pradesh. Another important news. Naomi Kawase named as the UNESCO's Goodwill Ambassador for Cultural and Creative Industries. Pradeep Shah appointed as the chairman of NARCL and Sanjay Jain appointed as the CEO of IDRCL. Sambit Patra appointed as the new chairman of India Tourism Development Corporation. Do mark this. You must have seen Sambit Patra ji on news channels debating on various issues. So he has been appointed as the new chairman of the India Tourism Development Corporation. Ravindra Jadeja ji appointed as the brand ambassador of Kinara Capital. Alka Upadhyay appointed as the chairperson of National Highways Authority of India. That is your NHAI. Very important question. Alka Upadhyay appointed as the chairperson of National Highways Authority of India. And Sanjay Bandopadhyay ji has been appointed as the chairman of Inland Waterways Authority of India. Very important. Mark this also. Sanjay Upadhyay. Now if I ask you, what is your National Waterway 1? It is located on which river? It is located on Ganga. And National Waterway 2 is located on Brahmaputra. And this is from Varanasi to Lucknow to Varanasi. Alright, it is from Lucknow to... from Allahabad to Varanasi. Allahabad to Varanasi. This is your National Waterway 1. And National Waterway 2 is located on Brahmaputra. Now shifting to the awards part. International Press Institute India has awarded for excellence in journalism 2021, given jointly to NDTV and The Week. I repeat, International Press Institute India Award for Excellence in Journalism. This is the name of the award and it is for excellence in journalism. That means someone who did excellent work in the field of journalism, and this award was given jointly to NDTV and The Week. Next is your Merriam-Webster has declared vaccine as the word of the year. We have discussed this multiple times. You should know either it will be vax or it will be vax. So you should know. So, and it was declared by Merriam-Webster vaccine of the year, and vax was basically, if I am correct, it was by Oxford. Both the means same, only vax or vaccine, related to your vaccine, so that it an awareness can be created about all the population should get vaccinated for coronavirus. Next is Bihar has won the gold medal award at 40th edition of India International Trade Fair of 2021. Very important. Next, V. Praveen Rao won the 7th Dr. M.S. Swaminathan Award for 2017 to 2019. Himachal Pradesh Police honored with President's Colour Award. Very important. Which state's police was honored with the President's Colour Award? It was your Himachal Pradesh Police. IGI, that is your Indira Gandhi International Airport of Delhi, has been adjudged as the or has been declared as the best airport in India and Central Asia in 2022 by Skytrax. So it was given this title of the best airport in India and Central Asia by Skytrax, and it was given to IGI Airport Delhi. Anju Bobby George won the Women of the Year award at World Athletics Award 2021. Very important, mark this. Next, Assam government has been awarded with Assam Baibhav Award for Ratan Tata. I repeat, Assam government has given Assam Baibhav Award to whom? It was given to Ratan Tata. Mark this, important. Ratan Tata was awarded with Assam Vaibhav Award, and it was given to them by which state government? It was given to by them by Assam state government. Next, Delhi's Nizamuddin Revival Project won 2 UNESCO Asia Pacific Award for Cultural Heritage Conservation 2021. So Delhi's Nizamuddin Revival Project won how many awards? They won 2 UNESCO awards. Next is mathematician Nikhil Srivastav, Adam Marcus and Daniel Spellman selected for inaugural AMS Cyprian Foyce Award. I repeat, AMS Cyprian Foyce Award was given to whom? It was given to mathematician Nikhil Srivastav, Adam Marcus and Daniel Spillman. Mark this. Next is ESAF SFB Small Finance Bank got honorable mention in Best Bank for Women Entrepreneurs at 4th Global SME Finance Award 2021. So which bank got the best honorable mention for Best Bank for Women Entrepreneurs? It was your ESAF Small Finance Bank. Next is your Neelmani Phukan Jr. and Damodar Maujo won the Gyanpith Award. Can you tell me which of them won the 56th and which one 57th? Neelmani Phukan Jr. win the 56th Gyanpith Award and 57th Gyanpith Award was won by Damodar Maujo ji. Moving on. Some defense questions now. Bangladesh, US will be conducting a bilateral exercise corporation afloat residence and training, that is CARAT. Mark this. CARAT will be conducted between Bangladesh and USA. Next, India and Maldives will be conducting a joint military exercise Ukraine that will be conducted in Maldives itself. It's apart from this, I told you, you have to remember exercise Dosti that is conducted between India, Sri Lanka and Maldives, and the location will be Maldives from where Dosti will be conducted. Next, Sandhyak, first of the four ships under the survey vessel project for Indian Navy launched at Kolkata. Mark this, Sandhyak. Sandhyak is the one of the four ships under the mission of survey vessel project that will be launched for Indian Navy, and the location where this Sandhyak was launched was your Kolkata. Next, Victor Axelsen. Now we are talking about some sports questions. Victor Axelsen, Tai Zhu Ying, has been named as the 2021 BWF Male and Female Player of the Year. That means by Badminton World Federation, who has been named as the best male player of the year. He is Victor Axelsen. And if we are talking about the best female player declared by Badminton World Federation, she is Tai Zhu Ying. Next is Russia defeated Croatia to win Davis Cup Tennis Tournament 2021 in Madrid. So who won the Davis Cup? It was won by Russia. Next, Lewis Hamilton has won the inaugural edition of Saudi Arabian GP. Argentina has won the 12th Men's FIH Junior Hockey World Cup of 2021 that was held in Odisha. Indian shuttler PV Sindhu won the silver at Badminton World Federation World Tour Finals of 2021, and Victor Axelsen and NC Young won the gold medal at the same event. So these were related to your sports. Now the important are the days. Let's look at some of the important days of December's first week. First comes your 1st of December, on which we observe World AIDS Day, and the theme of the World AIDS Day will be End Inequalities, End AIDS, and End Pandemics. So, three ends and one end, you need to remember End Inequalities, End AIDS, and End Pandemics. That will be the theme of the World AIDS Day. Then on 1st of December only, we observe Nagaland Statehood Day. 57th BSF Raising Day is also observed on 1st of December. Moving to 2nd December, we observe National Pollution Control Day. And on 2nd of December only, we observe International Day for the Abolition of Slavery with the theme Ending Slavery's Legacy of Racism, a Global Imperative for Justice. This is the theme for the International Day of for the Abolition of Slavery. On 2nd of December, we observe World Computer Literacy Day. On 3rd December, we observe International Day of Persons with Disabilities. And the theme of this day will be Leadership and Participation of Persons with Disabilities towards an Inclusive, Accessible and Sustainable Post-COVID-19 World. Then 4th of December, we observe Indian Navy Day, very important day. Indian Navy Day on 4th, and on 8th of October, we observe Air Force Day. Air Force Day, 15th Jan, we observe Army Day. Then on 4th of December only, we observe International Day of Banks. 5th December, we observe World Soil Day with the theme Halt Soil Salinization, Boost Soil Productivity. 5th December, we observe International Volunteers Day with the theme Volunteer for Now, for our Common Future. 6th December, we observe India-Bangladesh celebrated Maitri Divas. Very important day. Mark this. Maitri Divas observed between India and Bangladesh. And when was your Maitri Divas? It was on 6th of December. On 6th of December only, we observed Mahaparinirvan Divas. And on 7th December, we observed International Civil Aviation Day with the theme Advancing Innovation for Global Aviation Development. I repeat, theme being of International Civil Aviation Day is Advancing Innovation for Global Aviation Development. 7th December, we observed National Armed Forces Flag Day. So these were your some important days that once more, let me remind you. 1st of December is important, that is your World AIDS Day. 2nd of December, that is your National Pollution Control Day, as it is related to your environment and pollution. Then on 2nd of December, also remember, it is your World Computer Literacy Day. Then on 4th of December, it's your Indian Navy Day. 5th of December, World Soil Day. And then comes your 6th of December, that you should know, that is your Maitri Divas. And on 7th December, that is your National Armed Force Flag Day. Do remember this day also, because it is related to your armed forces. Alright friends, so these were your some important one-liner questions that I wanted to share of the first week of December. Now, based on these one-liners, let's move to the MCQ questions that will help you in revision. So, let's start. Read the first question. In November 2021, Alternative Mechanism approved the acquisition of 100% government stakes in Central Electronics Limited to Dash for 210 crore rupees. This Alternative Mechanism approved the acquisition of 100% of the Government of India stake of Central Electronics Limited to Nandal Financing and Leasing Private Limited. Nandal Finance and Leasing Private Limited for a worth of 210 crore rupees. This is the second strategic stake sale by the Government of India after Air India. Next question. Now you have to tell me which of the options among A, B, C are correct. These are with respect to the 52nd International Film Festival of India that was held at Goa in November 2021. First option, Saving One Who Is Dead movie won the best film under the Golden Peacock Award in the IFFI 2021. Let me read it again. Saving One Who Is Dead. This is the name of the movie that won the best film under the Golden Peacock Award in IFFI 2021. So is A option correct? No, option A is wrong. Saving One Who Is Dead is not the movie who won the Golden Peacock Award. It was Ring Wandering is the name of the movie that won the best film under Golden Peacock Award. So A option is wrong. B option, Jitendra Bhikulal Joshi won the best actor and Angela Molina of Spain won the best film actor award. So yes, B option is correct. Moving to C, Hema Malini and Prasoon Joshi won the 2021 Indian Film Personality of the Year award. Yes, we have discussed this. C option is also correct. So only B and C are correct. Moving on. Also remember, during this, one award was started or one award was given for the first time. Can you tell me what is the name of the award? Name the award that was given for the first time during the IFFI 2021. What is the name of the award? Comment below. This is your homework. This is homework number one. Mark it. All right. Because I see when I'm giving you homework, you are not answering the questions in the comment. So this is your homework below. I'll be counting the number of questions that are given to you in homework. And I'll make sure that you are answering all the questions in the comment section below. It will be beneficial for you. So this is your homework one. Name the award that was started for the first time in IFFI 2021. Next, RBI suspended the board of Dash for exercising its power conferred to the Section 45(1)(e) of the RBI Act 1934 and also appointed Dash as the new administrator of the company. We just saw this question in the one-liner format. If you would have paid attention, answer would have been came easily to you, running towards you. So, RBI suspended the board of Reliance Capital Limited for exercising its power conferred to the Section 45(1)(e). Also remember who was appointed Nageshwar Rao, why appointed as the new administrator of the company. So the correct option becomes option 2. Next, name the organization that has approved a loan of worth $125 million for water supply and sanitization projects in Uttarakhand. Simple. Again, if you would have paid attention, you would have guessed the answer. But now it was your ADB, Asian Development Bank, approved the loan of worth $125 million for water supply and sanitization projects in which state? Remember the name of the state also, Uttarakhand. Next. Similarly, you have to write which of the correct is answer with respect to the Ballon d'Or award. Christian, first of all, remember this Ballon d'Or award is given to the personalities of who play football. Sport, football. Related to which sport? It is related to football. Next, Cristiano Ronaldo won the Ballon d'Or award for the fourth time, and Alexia Putellas won the Women's Ballon d'Or award. So is option A correct according to you? No, option A is not correct. Why? Because he was not Cristiano Ronaldo who won the Ballon d'Or award. He was Lionel Messi won the Ballon d'Or award for the fourth time, and Alexia Putellas. Was she Alexia Putellas from the women's who won the Ballon d'Or award for the first time? Yes, it was. She was Alexia Putellas who won the women's Ballon d'Or award. Next, so your option becomes wrong. Second is Bayern Munich striker Robert Lewandowski won the Striker of the Year award for 2021. Yes, it is absolutely correct. Third, Ballon d'Or is an annual football award presented by the French magazine France Football since 1956. Yes, option C is also correct. So here only option only B and C are correct. Next, who was recently appointed as the new chief executive officer of the Twitter? Let me give you a hint. He was an Indian who was appointed as the new CEO of Twitter. Earlier, he was the chief technical officer. Now he has been promoted to the post of CEO of Twitter. He is Prag Agarwal. Moving on to the next question. Also remember, if the question is asked, who is the former CEO of Twitter? He is Jack Dorsey. Next question. Who became the first female prime minister of Sweden in November? We saw this question also. Very easy question. Who was she? She was Magdalena Andersson. She became the first female. That is the reason this question is important. First female prime minister of Sweden, Magdalena Andersson. Next. Name the new communication satellite that was launched by China for radio and television transmission services. What is the name of this new communication satellite? Zhongxing 1D is this the name of the new satellite launched by China from Xizhang Satellite Launch Center that is located in Sichuan province. Just remember, it was Zhongxing 1D, a new satellite, a new communication satellite launched by China. And one more thing you need to remember, if the rocket asked here, rocket was Long March 3B carrier rocket that took it into space. Next, the government allowed 100% FDI in airlines and relaxed norms for overseas investment in brownfield airports. Which Indian state received the highest FDI in 2021? What is FDI? FDI is your foreign direct investment. So the question directly asked here is that which is the state that received the highest foreign direct investment? It was received by the state of Karnataka. Very and good and important question. The state that received the highest foreign direct investment was Karnataka. Very important. All right. And if we are talking about for fiscal year 21-22, then of the total, 48% was received by Karnataka. Maharashtra received approximately of 23% and Delhi received an approximate of 11% of foreign direct investment. Next, The Ministry of Commerce and Industry has approved the continuation of the scheme for investment promotion, that is your SIP, for Dash with a financial outlay of 970 crore rupees to promote FDI into India. So remember, the Ministry of Commerce and Industry has approved the continuation of the scheme for investment promotion, that is SIP, for a term of how many years? For a term of 5 years with a financial outlay of rupees 970 crore rupees to promote FDI into India. So if the question is asked, which is the implementation agency here? Implementation agency will be DPIIT. Now what is DPIIT? Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade was your implementation agency for this 5 years financial program. Next question. You have to tell me which of the options is correct from ABC with respect to the economic weaker section EVS and the committee that was set up to review its annual income criteria. So read the option A. It is saying that the Ministry of Law and Justice formed a 5-member committee to review the annual income criteria for EWS reservation. So which was it? The Ministry of Law and Justice? No, it was your Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment that set up this member committee, and it was not a 5-member committee, it was a 3-member committee that was set up for economic weaker sections reservations. So A option becomes wrong. Moving to second B part, creamy layer concept was introduced from the Keshav Nanda Bharti case 1992, which set the annual family income of rupees 5 lakh rupees for an inclusion from reservation benefits of OBCs. So is B option correct? No, it was wrong again, because it was not introduced from the Keshav Nanda Bharti case. It was introduced in the Indira Sahani judgment. It was introduced in Indira Sahani judgment. Remember this, and it was of 1992 only that started this creamy layer procedure. So option C is also wrong. Now move to the C part. It is saying that 10% reservations for EWS quota was introduced under 103 Constitution Amendment Act of 2019. So yes, C option is the only one that is correct. So option 3 is correct here. Next, which bank launched India's first standalone metal debit card that is called First Private Infinite? I repeat, the name of the first standalone metal debit card is known as First Private Infinite in partnership with Visa. So which bank has partnered with Visa to issue these standalone metal debit cards for the first time, and they are the First Private Infinite, the name of these credit cards. So tell me, which is the name of the bank that started this service? Which is the bank? It is your bank, that is IDFC First Bank, are issuing this metal debit cards, that is your First Private Infinite. All right, now moving on to the second question. In November, National Statistics Office, that is your NSO, estimated India's GDP will grow by -% in the second quarter of 2022. It is expected that, according to NSO is saying that they have projected that India's GDP will grow by 8.4% in second quarter of fiscal year 2022. Next, which state has signed Sanjay Dutt as the brand ambassador and Rahul Mitra as the brand advisor for the 50th year of celebration? So we have just saw this, that Sanjay Dutt was appointed as the brand ambassador and Rahul Mitra as the brand advisor for its 50th year of celebration of which state? It was your Arunachal Pradesh. Very important, mark this. On the occasion of their Golden Jubilee celebration that marks the 50th anniversary or 50 year celebration of Arunachal Pradesh, Sanjay Dutt was appointed their brand ambassador. Next, when is your World AIDS Day celebrated and what is the theme of it? The day is observed on 1st of December and the theme being and equality and AIDS. Remember, the more the number of and, the likelier the option for the theme will be of World AIDS Day 2021. Next, it is related to your static question. It is saying that Indian Air Force Group Captain Abhinandan Vartman ji has been honored with the Veer Chakra Gallantry Award by President of India. Question here asked is that which is the highest gallantry award of India? So which is the highest gallantry award of India? It is your Paramveer Chakra is the highest gallantry award of India. And if I ask you which is the highest Padma award? It is your Padma Vibhushan is the highest Padma award. And if we are talking about the highest civilian award, highest civilian award, this is which is the highest civilian award of India, the award is Bharat Ratna. Mark these 2-3 questions, they are very important. All right, moving on. Which country recently became the world's newest republic? So recently a new country has been declared and it was earlier under the leadership of Britain. So now they have become their independent country. What is the name of the country? It is your Barbados. Barbados became the world's new republic after 396 years of British monarchy. So now they have become the newest republic. And if question asked, what is the name of their first president of Barbados? First president, who he will be? Dame Sandra Prunella Manchin. He has been appointed as the first president of the world's newest republic, that is Barbados. Next, on 1st December, the presidency of G20 has been changed to dash from Italy. So who is having the presidency of G20 now? Indonesia is having the presidency of G20. Earlier it was with Italy. Thereby India will, which will host the G20 presidency from dash to dash, enter the G2 Troika. See, all 2-3 questions given here that you should know. First, it is saying that on December 2021, the presidency of G20 has been changed to. So now who is having the presidency of G20? It is with Indonesia. Alright, earlier it was with Italy. And now it is saying thereby India, which will host the G20 presidency from dash to dash. India will be having the presidency from 2022 to 2023. Enter the G20 Troika. We just saw what was Troika. Troika was a combination of 3 countries and they are India, Italy and Indonesia. India, Italy and Indonesia. I told you my friends earlier only that if you would have paid attention, or still I'm giving an option, that stop the video here itself, go and revise the first 10 to 15 minutes of our video where I'm teaching you the one-liners. Just go through them and after that you will be practicing these questions. They will be nothing compared to you. You will be like, they are so easy questions. So the correct option here becomes option C. Next, according to the 10th annual World Cooperative Monitor report, which company ranked the number one cooperative among the top 300 cooperatives in the world? Come on, tell me. Indian Farmers Fertilizers Cooperative Limited has been appointed or has been ranked the number one cooperative among the top 300 cooperatives in the world. So it is your what? It is your Indian Farmers Fertilizers Limited Cooperative has been the number one or has been ranked number one in the cooperatives among the 300 cooperatives, and this came under the annual World Cooperative Monitor, and that was through the 10th edition of this monitor. Next, now you have to tell me which of the following is correct with respect to the 11th edition of the World Migration Report of 2022. A option, global international migration increased from 84 million globally in 1970 to 281 million in 2020. Yes, option A is correct. B option, India has the largest emigration population in the world and also the largest recipient of remittance totaling $83 billion. Yes, that is also correct, as India has the largest emigration population in the world. Next comes your International Organization for Migration of the United Nations launched the 11th edition of the World Migration Report of 2022. Yes, C option is also here correct, that IMO of the United Nations launched the 11th edition of this World Migration Report, IOM, not IMO. So correct option here becomes, all are correct, A, B and C. Next is, according to the state finances, this is the name of the report, that is State Finances, a study of the budgets of 21-22 that was released by RBI. Combined debt to GDP ratio of the states is expected to remain at 10% by the end of 2022, which is higher than the target of 20% that will be achieved in the so-and-so fiscal year. So first of all, remember the name of the report, that is State Finances, a study of the budgets of 21-22, and which is the organization that released this. It is released by RBI. It is saying that the debt to GDP ratio of state is expected to remain at what percent? It is expected to remain at 31% by the end of March 2022. That is higher than the target of 20% that is to be achieved in the fiscal year of 23. So the correct option here becomes option 4th. Next question is, which ministry has signed an MOU with Paytm to train 6,000 individuals for 3 years in the fintech industry? So which company has tied up, or which ministry has tied up with Paytm? It is your Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. As we are talking about skill development, so it is your Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship that has tied up with Paytm. Next, name the bank that has launched a saving bank product, that is Mahila Mitra Plus, to provide financial planning and investments for women. I repeat, Mahila Mitra Plus. This is a saving bank product that was launched by which bank for the financial planning and investment for women? What is the name of the bank that launched it? It was your Federal Bank. Next, in December, Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development estimated India's GDP to grow by what percent? The Organization for Economic Cooperation has estimated India's GDP to grow by 9.4% for fiscal year 2022. Next question, who won the Women of the Year 2021 award from the World Athletics? It was won by Anju Bobby George. Remember, she won the Women of the Year award 2021 from World Athletics. Very important. Anju Bobby George has won this, and she plays for what athletic event? She's a long jump, former long jumper. Next, who got appointed as the UNESCO's Goodwill Ambassador for Cultural and Creative Industries in December 2022. Who was he? She was Naomi Kawase, has been appointed as the UNESCO's Goodwill Ambassador for Cultural and Creative Industries. We discussed this in one-liners. Next. And if we talk about what is the role of this UNESCO's Goodwill Ambassador, it is to utilize their talent and visibility to promote UNESCO's values and objectives, to spread UNESCO's value, that means the good values and the good, all the schemes, all the related to sustainable development goals, any theme that we are coming up, to spread education or to spread awareness that how education is important in students and how cleanliness is important. So various initiatives are taken, and the work of these ambassadors are to create awareness and to spread awareness regarding these particular events. Next is your, which company has signed a contract with Indian Army worth 471 crore rupees to supply IGLA M1 missiles? It is signed by Bharat Dynamics Limited, that is your BDL. Next, which company is developing the world's first sustainable floating city along with Oceanix and UN Habitat? Just remember, if the question comes, world's first sustainable floating city or world's first floating city is being developed by which country? It is your South Korea. Very important question. You should know this. Next, and this is likely to be completed by the year 2025. Name the organization that has approved a $50 million loan to Samagra Siksha for improving the quality of school education in India. So, organization that approved a loan of $500 million टू समग्र शिक्षा फॉर इम्प्रूविंग द क्वालिटी ऑफ स्कूल एजुकेशन इन इंडिया इज योर एशियन डेवलपमेंट बैंक दैट इज योर ADB फॉर इम्प्रूविंग और टू सपोर्ट समग्र शिक्षा अभियान फॉर इम्प्रूविंग द क्वालिटी ऑफ स्कूल एजुकेशन इन इंडिया. Next is another important question. We just discussed it, that who was appointed as the IMF, that is your International Monetary Fund's first deputy managing director. Who is he or who is she? Her name is Geeta Gopinath. Very important. Indian American origin, first female chief economist of International Monetary Fund, that is Geeta Gopinath, has been promoted to the IMF's first deputy managing director. Very important. Yes, and if we are talking about IMF, then you should know who is the MD, that is your managing director of IMF. She is Kristalina Georgieva. IMF was established in 1944 and Washington DC is the headquarter. Kuno National Park, I repeat, Kuno National Park is set to get 13 African cheetahs in 2022. In which state is Kuno National Park located? Tell me. Easy question. Where is Kuno National Park located? It is located in Madhya Pradesh. Kuno National Park. Next. Indian tennis star Rohan Bopanna got the Rajyotsav Award. Recently, this Rajyotsava Award is the second highest civilian award for which state? This Rajyotsava Award is the second highest civilian award of Karnataka. Next, also remember that on 1st of November, this award, that is Rajyotsav Award, was given to whom? It was given to Rohan Bopanna, and on 1st of November only. Why? Because on 1st of November we observe, or the people there observe, Kannad Rajyotsava. Alright, on 1st of November. Next, name the India's first indigenous server that was recently launched by MOS, that is your Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, Rajiv Chandrasekhar ji, which was developed by CDAC under the National Supercomputing Mission. So the name of this indigenous supercomputer is your Rudra. Or name of this indigenous server, basically, not supercomputer, it is the indigenous server. And it was named as Rudra. Mark this. Alright. What is the full form of CDAC here? CDAC stands for Center for Development of Advanced Computing. I repeat, Center for Development of Advanced Computing. Alright. And Rudra is a server. Next. In December, PM Modi has laid the foundation stone for 11 projects in Dash State, including the foundation stone for Dash Economic Corridor project, which was Asia's largest wildlife elevated corridor. So we just discussed this, that he spent around how much? Around 2500 crore rupees and more than that in the, or you can say around 18,000 crore rupees for the development of which? Dehradun. And he also laid the foundation stone of the Delhi-Dehradun Economic Corridor project. So option 3 is correct here. Identify the organization that has partnered with International Telecommunication Union to conduct joint cyber drill of 2021. It was done by the Department of Telecommunications. If we are talking about ITU, ITU is your International Telecommunication Union. Secretary General is Hou Lin Zhao. Headquarter of this will be in Geneva, Switzerland. And it was founded in 1865. Next question. Where was the 22nd edition of Dhanesh Bird Festival, also known as the Festival of Festivals, celebrated? So, where is the Festival of Festivals celebrated? It is celebrated in Nagaland. That is also known as Dhanesh Bird Festival. Mark this, another important question. So, it is your 22nd edition of it. Do remember this also. 22nd edition of Dhanesh Bird Festival, or known as the Festival of Festivals, celebrated in Nagaland. Next, Also, one more thing you should remember, that this festival, that is your Hornbill Festival. Recently, 22nd edition of Hornbill Festival began in Nagaland at Naga Heritage, Kohima. The governor of Assam and Nagaland inaugurated the 10-day festival. This festival is also called, that is your Hornbill Festival. So many names you should know. Hornbill, Dhanesh Bird Festival, or the Festival of Festivals. That is the reason I told you to remember this question. This is very important. See, we used to remember that it is your Hornbill Festival, but this is also known as Dhanesh Bird Festival or the Festival of Festivals observed by Nagaland people. Also, in Nagaland, we observe Nagada Festival, Hega Festival, then Memkut Festival. These three festivals are also observed by the people of Nagaland. Next question. Which state surpassed Maharashtra to become the India's top manufacturing hub as per the data released by RBI? So the state that became or that has surpassed Maharashtra is Gujarat to become the India's top manufacturing hub. If question is asked, which is India's leading state in the terms of service sector? In the terms of service sector, it is still Maharashtra. And if we are talking about manufacturing sector, it has taken up by Gujarat. Next, the Badminton World Federation named Victor Axelsen from Dash. He is from Denmark as the male player of the year, while Taiwan's Dash Tai Zhu Ying awarded with the female player of the year. That means if we are talking about Victor Axelsen, he is from which country? He is from Denmark. And if we are talking about female player, that is Tai Zhu Ying, she is from which state or which country? She is from Taiwan, who has been awarded with the female player of the year by Badminton World Federation. So the correct option here becomes option 5. Next, name the Indian Small Finance Bank that was under the honorable mentions in the Best Banks for Women Entrepreneurs category in the 4th Global SME Finance Award. We discussed this, that the Indian Small Finance Bank that has been the categorized under the Best Bank for Women Entrepreneurs category is your ESAF Small Finance Bank. It was launched in 2017, and the MD and CEO of this ESAF Small Finance Bank is Kadambelli Paul Thomas. Next question. Dash become the first Indian state to launch Banadhikar app. I repeat, Banadhikar app, that is a GPS based mobile application for demarcating forest patta for the landless indigenous people under the Forest Right Act of Dash. See, Tripura became the first Indian state to launch the Banadhikar app, that is a GPS based mobile app for demarcating forest patta for the landless indigenous people under the Forest Right Act of 2006. So it was your Tripura state. Next question. Which bank has launched the revised mobile banking app MPay Delight to enable the public to make various payments? I repeat, the bank that launched the revised mobile banking app MPay Delight was, what was the name of the bank? It was your Jammu and Kashmir Bank that start the MPay Delight system. Next comes your, who won the presidential election of Gambia for the second term in December? So presidential election of Gambia for the second term was won by Adama Barrowji. Next, who was appointed as the chairperson of National Highways Authority of India? Who was he? She is Alka Upadhyay. Alka Upadhyay has been appointed as the chairperson of the NHAI, that is your National Highway Authority of India. Very important, mark this. Next, name the first survey vessel project that was launched for the Indian Navy by Garden Reach Shipbuilders and Engineers Limited in the West Bengal. We just did this. What was the name of this vessel? It was your Sandhyak vessel. Sandhyak vessel was the project launched for the Indian Navy by GRSE, that is Garden Reach Shipbuilders and Engineers Limited in West Bengal. Next, according to the report titled Reckoning with the US Role in Global Ocean Plastic Waste, which country is the biggest plastic polluter? So the country, indirectly it is saying which is the country that is the largest, biggest or the which is the biggest plastic polluter in the world. So the biggest plastic polluter is your United States of America. Next, Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, that is your CSIR, Indian Institute of Petroleum to produce biojet fuel, has been formally approved for the use of military aircrafts of the Indian Air Force. Where is this CSIR IIP located? This is located in Dehradun, Uttarakhand. If the question is asked, where is the headquarter of just CSIR located? So it is located in New Delhi, and at the headquarter of CSIR IIP, that is your Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. IIP stands for Indian Institute of Petroleum. Their headquarter is in where? Its headquarter is in Dehradun, Uttarakhand. Next, according to the Ministry of MSME, nearly 25,000 MSMEs registered for PM Modi's MSME certification scheme Zero Defect, Zero Effect. Who is the Union Minister of this MSME? Who is he? Narayan Tatu Raniji is the Union Minister of MSME. Simple and direct question is being asked here. Nothing important to remember. Next, you have to tell me which of the following ABC is correct with respect to the 21st Indian-Russia Annual Summit. Option A. During the summit, both countries' ministers hold their first 2+2 defense ministry level dialogue in New Delhi. Is option A is correct? Yes, option A is correct. Let's look at B. Both nations renewed the Military Tactical Cooperation Agreement for another 10 years till 2031 and also signed the deal for the manufacture of AK-203 assault rifles. Yes, it was signed between India and Russia, we just saw. Alright, yesterday also we did the question that AK-230 rifles will be procured by India from which country? It will be from Russia. So option B is also correct. C is India and Russia signed 28 MOUs and set a target of bilateral trade worth $30 billion by 2025. C option here is also correct. So all options are correct. Next, in December, the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change has declared Kazuvali Wetlands as the 16th bird sanctuary of which state? Very important, as I told you. 16th bird sanctuary of which state? It is of Tamil Nadu. That means Kazuvali Wetland is located in Tamil Nadu. Question can be asked that Kazuvali Wetland has been declared as the 16th bird sanctuary by which ministry? It is the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change that declared them as the 16th bird sanctuary of Tamil Nadu. Next is your the Center for Science and Environment and Dash released a report that was Waste Wise Cities Best Practices in Municipal Solid Waste Management that documented the best practices in solid waste management from 28 cities in 15 states of India. So it was along with which organization? Center for Science and Environment along with Niti Aayog did this. Alright, this Niti Aayog and Center for Science and Environment released the report that is your Waste Wise Cities Best Practices in Municipal Solid and Waste Management. Alright, the report documents the best practices of solid waste management from the 28 cities in the 15 states of India. If we are talking about Niti Aayog, Niti Aayog was established on 1st of January in 2015. Its headquarters is in New Delhi and the chairperson who is the current Prime Minister of India, that means currently Narendra Modi is the chairperson of Niti Aayog. Next, which ministry launched Shreshth Yojana and National Fellowship Management and Grievance Redressal Portal at Dr. Ambedkar International Center, New Delhi? Which is the ministry that launched the Shreshth Yojana and National Fellowship Management and Grievance Redressal Portal? It was launched by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Launched this Shreshth Yojana and National Fellowship Management and Grievance Redressal Portal. Next, as per the report of top 100 arms producing and military services companies of 2020 that was released by SIPRI, India's Hindustan Aeronautics Limited and Indian Ordnance Factories, and Dash ranks among the top 100 manufacturers globally, while the US Lockheed Martin Corps tops Dash. Alright, so you have to tell me that as per the report of this that was released by SIBRI, India's Hall, Indian Ordnance Factories and Bharat Electronics Limited ranks among the top 100 manufacturers. Alright, that is your Bharat Electronics Limited and your India's Hindustan Aeronautic Limited and Indian Ordnance Factories. These are the three companies that are ranked among the top 100 manufacturers globally, while the United States Lockheed Martin Corps is topping this. Alright, topping this, matlab, these are on the, this US United States Lockheed Martin Corps is on the top. Corps stands for corporation. Next, which small finance bank partnered with India Gold to launch India's first loan against digital gold? It is your Shivalik Small Finance Bank. I repeat, the small finance bank is your Shivalik Small Finance Bank that has partnered with India Gold to launch India's first loan against the digital gold. Next, who became the first female president of Honduras in December 2021 election? She was Xiomara Castro. Xiomara Castro became the first female president of Honduras. Next, Dash was appointed as the MD and CEO of Ujjain Small Finance Bank for Dash years. Ithira Davis has been appointed as the MD, that is your Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of Small Finance Bank for a term of 3 years. So the correct option is option 4. Next, during the test match series, Ravichandra Ashwin became the Dash Indian to take 300 wickets. He became the second Indian to take 300 wickets at home for India, and Dash Ajaz Patel created history in the test cricket by taking all 10 wickets in a single inning. So this was a history made here or a record made here. So that is important. Remember the name of Ajaz Patel. He took all the 10 wickets in a single inning. And Ravichandra Ashwin become the second player to take 300 wickets for at home for India. So the correct option is option 5. A good news to all our viewers. Recently, we have launched a course that is IBPS PO exam course. This is a 25-day free course to crack IBPS PO mains exams. This course duration will be from 13th of December to 14th of January. This course will help you to boost your preparation. This course could be attempted any number of time with no day limit. In this course, we'll be providing you information related to your admit card details, previous year cutoffs, notification related to such exam and many other details. Apart from this, you can see here, we are covering the whole syllabus here, like data analysis on D3, then you are getting quiz of 20 questions with such questions that you can prepare that will help you, or they are the expected questions that will be coming in the exams. So these questions are very helpful. These 20 questions you will be getting on daily basis and they will help you to boost your preparation. So go fast and subscribe to this course.
तो फ्रेंड्स, ये थी हमारी वीडियो। अगर आपको आज हमारी वीडियो से कुछ ना कुछ सीखने को मिला है तो जल्दी से जाइए और हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर दें और इस वीडियो को लाइक कर दें। और फ्रेंड्स, अगर आपको हमारे कंटेंट से रिलेटेड या फिर हमारी कोई ऐप से इशू आ रहा है, कोई भी आपको प्रॉब्लम है, तो आप हमारी जीमेल आईडी जो कि है support@affairscloud.com या फिर हमारा नंबर 9677333862 पर कॉन्टैक्ट कर सकते हैं एंड हमारी टीम जल्दी से जल्दी आपके इशू को रिजॉल्व करने में आपकी सहायता करेगी। सो टेक केयर।